Good morning to all of you. I am Mr. C.N. Patil, assistant teacher in H.R. Patel Arts and Science Junior College, Shirpur, District Dhule. Today, I want to present poem number 2, Indian Weavers, Standard 12, English New Syllabus. Indian Weavers by Sarojini Nayadu. Lifespan of Sarojini Nayadu, 1879 to 1949, and she is known as the Nightingale of India. Sarojini Nayadu was a political activist, feminist, and the first Indian woman who became the president of Indian National Congress. She was an important figure in India's struggle for independence. She was known as Nightingale of India. Later, she became the governor of the United Provinces in 1947, becoming the first woman to hold the office of the governor in independent India. Indian Weavers is a very short poem where the poet talks about three types of garment that the weavers view at three particular times of a day. Each stanza of the poem represents the three important events of human life: childhood, adulthood, and old age. The colors mentioned in the stanzas are very significant as they indicate the moods related to the events. See the poem, only three stanzas, four lines in each stanza. Now we will see the poem Indian Weavers by Sarojini Nayadu. See the picture of Indian weavers, their craft, and in which way they are weaving. We will see the first stanza. Weavers weaving at break of day. Weavers weaving at break of day. Why do you weave a garment so gay? Gay in the sense happy. Why do you weave a garment so gay? Blue as the wing of a halcyon wild. Blue as the wing of a halcyon wild. We view the robes of a newborn child. We view the robes of a newborn child. In the first stanza, the poet asks the weavers why they are weaving cloths early in the morning, which seems to be quite beautiful and charming. Charming in the sense gay, happy. And the clothes are blue as the wing of halcyon wild. Halcyon is the other name of the kingfisher. The wings of the kingfisher are bright blue in color. In addition, blue color also symbolizes loyalty. The blue color thus symbolizes something beautiful and precious. Hence, in this stanza, the cloths weaved by the weavers are quite special, and this is why the poet is curious to know about them. The Indian weavers reply, "We weave the robes of a newborn child." That is, they are weaving the beautiful dress for a young one who had just came to the world. In this stanza, a number of images are used to describe the first stage of human life, like break of day, garments so gay, and blue as the wing of halcyon wild. This stage is full of happiness, freshness, hope, beauty, etc. There is no sorrow in the stage. Now we will turn towards the second stanza. In the second stanza, weavers weaving at a fall of night in the sense evening. Weavers weaving at a fall of night. Why do you view a garment so bright? Like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green. Plumes, it means soft feathers. We view the marriage veils of a queen. In the second stanza, the poet again meets the Indian weavers, this time during the fall of night, means evening time. And it probably refers to the evening or dusk time when the sun sets and darkness paves the way. Moreover, it is also the time during which most of the Indian marriages take place. The poet questions the weavers why they weave a garment so bright like the plumes of peacock, purple and green. The garment at this time is bright and full of colors like feathers of peacock, unlike the one color blue. The weavers reply that time they view the marriage veils of a queen, thus referring to the second, or in the words adult, stage of the life. During this stage, humans are quite active. They love each other, get married, and quest for a better, and the colors purple and green symbolizes sorrow and happiness, or struggle and ease in one's adult stage. And these all colors or ups and downs of life make the adulthood bright. Now we will turn towards the third stanza. Weavers weaving solemn and still, what do you view in the moonlight chill? Weavers weaving solemn and still, what do you view in the moonlight chill? White as feather and white as a cloud. White as a feather and white as a cloud, we view the dead man's funeral shroud. We view a dead man's funeral shroud. In the final stanza, the poet finds weavers solemn and still. That is, they are quiet, sorrowful, grieved, and silent. They are something wired in the moonlight chill, that is in the dead of the night, which is white as feather and white as cloud, that is colorless life. As the poet fails to figure out what is the cloth, it means the cloth, and why they are sorrowful and silent. She asks them, what are they weaving rather than why are they weaving? They reply that they are weaving shroud. Shroud in the sense cloth put on the dead body for dead person. Thus, the third and final stage is death, which is emotionless and lifeless like a white cloud or feather. In this way, the life which begins with the life, joy, hope, etc., ends with sorrow and grief. Now we will see the key points of Indian weavers. Indian weavers by Sarojini Nayadu sum up the life of human beings on earth in three main stages by using symbols like clothes and times of the day. See, the day begins with morning, and the journey of life begins with one color, blue, which means joy and happiness. The journey of life begins with birth, and the color blue means joy and happiness. it continues with addition of a number of colors, green and purple, which means sorrows also enter into the life along with happiness. Life is more active in this stage than in the first stage. In the second stanza, the life of humans are active, they love with each other, and lives and downs are always there. In the final stanza, it means in the night, at the old age, all the color vanishes and only single color remains, and it is white, which means emotions are connected with life, and when the person dies, emotions also dies. So in this way, this is a very simple and meaningful poem by Sarojini Nayadu. So once again, I thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel, like it and comment on it. Once again, thank you.